All right, in today's foundational technology skills tutorial, we're going to talk about hyperlinks, and I'm going to show you really quickly how you can make one. So first of all, I'm just going to show you what a hyperlink is so that you understand how to use it. So let's say that I go to a website like Crash Course, and I want to get this website URL and paste it somewhere else so that when someone clicked on these words, they would be taken back to this website. So the way I could do that is by copying the link and then pasting it onto another document. So you'll see here that this link has already been auto-generated as a hyperlink. And one of the ways that I can tell it is a hyperlink is because it is colored blue, which is the generic color for a hyperlink. And you'll see when I hover my mouse over it and click, that a little thumbnail drops down, and that tells me that this is a live hyperlink. So what does that mean? If I click on this, it's going to take me directly to that website. All right, so we have a live hyperlink here that's already been pre-created for us, but we can still do some things with it in order to further customize it. So for example, you might not want this to read this entire website URL, and instead you might just want it to say Crash Course. So the way I could do that is by clicking on the hyperlink, and then I'm going to go over here to the Edit Link button. And for the text, I'm going to change the text to just say Crash Course. When I click Apply, you'll see that it is still a blue hyperlink. It will still take me to the Crash Course website, but now I get to customize what the text actually looks like. Similarly, you could also change the URL. So if you did not actually want to direct people to Crash Course and instead wanted them to go to National Geographic, you could type that link instead, select it, and then rather than taking you to Crash Course, now you'll see that someone would be taken to nationalgeographic.com. Okay, so with this case, the hyperlink was already partially created for us. So how do we actually just create one from scratch? So I'm gonna go ahead and delete this Crash Course here. And now I'm just going to write a website where I want somebody to go. So here I'll start with something like dictionary.com. So I'm gonna type www.dictionary.com. And you'll notice in this document, because it's smart, that's already detected where I want to go, and it's already created a hyperlink that's going to take me to dictionary.com. All right, but what would happen if I just type something like dictionary.com? Would that work too? No. When I click off of it, it doesn't create its own hyperlink, so now I'm actually going to need to create one. So the way I'm going to do that is by highlighting over where I want to create the hyperlink, and then I have a few different options for how I can add one here. One choice is that I could go up here and I could click insert and go to insert link. You'll see that's going to give me the same option where I can customize the text and I can also customize the link. So here I'm going to send it to dictionary.com and click apply and I'll have a hyperlink. The other option is that I highlight the text and I'm going to either right click or put two finger clicks depending on what type of computer you're using. And I'm going to go down to link. And then again, I'll be given the option to create a hyperlink. And the last option is for me to go up to one of these shortcut keys, find the insert link icon, click it, and again, you'll see that that's going to pop up my menu. Click apply, you'll see I've created a hyperlink. You'll remember from before that you can actually hyperlink anything. So for example, you could just say, go to the online dictionary, highlight online dictionary, create a link out of that, click apply, and that will turn online dictionary into a live link. One last thing I want to show you here about hyperlinks is that they're not limited to text only. You can also create a hyperlink out of an image. So here, for example, you would just click on the image, and then you can go through the same different options in order to create that hyperlink. So I could go up to my shortcut here, click insert link, and then I can write the website address, dictionary.com, click it, click apply, and when somebody clicks on the image, they'll see that there's a dropdown and they can click on the link and it will take them to dictionary.com. All right, I hope this video helped you understand a little bit more about the basics of how to create a hyperlink.